Hi, and welcome to this first little video session of your program Yoga for Stress and Anxiety. In this session, we're going to practice one of the most powerful tools, if not the most powerful tool, of Hatha Yoga. It's a practice that really lends yoga its healing potential, its healing capacity. And also, it's a tool, it's a practice that you can use anywhere, from now, anytime, any place. You can use it to gather some control over your mental emotional state. You can use it to create a little space from the busyness of the mind. Those of you that practice yoga probably guess what I'm talking about. It's called your breath. So yes, it's been with you since the day you were born, but probably, unless you're familiar with the yoga breathing practices, you've been unaware as to how it can really support you and how you can use it for your physical, mental, emotional well-being. So what I want to do now is, in the audio sessions that you've got for this module one, and actually for all the modules really, the yoga practice modules, you're going to have to use this breath to support them, for them to work most effectively for you. If you've been practicing yoga, you might think it's nothing new to me. I know the yogic way of breathing, but please watch anyway, because maybe you'll learn a little, you'll get a slightly different angle on it. Maybe you've been taught a different way. Okay. So we're going to learn the breath lying down. It's called abdominal breathing. Well, not really, of course, breathing into the abdomen. We're breathing into the lowest part of the lungs. We're also going to be regulating the breathing. Regulating the breathing helps to balance the nervous system. So again, I don't want to go into that too much now. It's explained more fully in your guidebook. I feel it's important that you understand why we're doing something, because that will also maybe add impetus to your practice, inspire you to actually do it if you have the understanding as to the science behind it. Also, from a Western perspective and from an Eastern esoteric perspective, there's a science behind this use and regulation of the breath. So, I've got a bolster here which we can come to later, and a meditation cushion which we'll come to later, because we're going to learn to do this practice both sitting and lying. But we'll start lying on the mat. So you do need a yoga mat or a rug or a folded up blanket. It's best that you're on a firm surface, so not on the bed or the sofa, okay? Level your chin over your chest. I'm going to turn my head so I can talk to you. Bend the knees, feet are underneath the knees, about hip distance apart. Relax the shoulders into the mat and bring your left hand onto your belly. And then, just without start changing anything, you can close your eyes if you like. Keep your chin turned to the center of your chest. Anytime you're not sure what I'm saying, then of course you can glimpse, you can have a look at what I'm doing. But it's nice to really start to feel inwardly and connect inwardly with your breath. So just feel the movement of your breath in your torso without changing anything, even if you're familiar with yoga breathing. Observe the state of your breath right now. Is it shallow? Are you breathing into your chest mainly? Does your belly rise and fall already with your breath? Does it feel tight, restricted? Or is your breath free and open? These things are a great indication of our mental state, of the state of our nervous system. The more stressed we are, the more shallow, irregular, tight the breathing is likely to be. Some of you are familiar with this, some of you are familiar with it being difficult to take a breath in, even when you're feeling stressed, anxious. And then I'm going to ask you to, on your next exhalation, just gently draw your belly away from your hand, back towards the spine. Inhale, just relax the belly. Let the belly rise up towards your hand. Exhale, softly, gently draw the belly back. We're always breathing through the nose, by the way, in yoga. Inhale. Belly rises. Exhale. Feel your belly fall back away from your spine. Keep working like that. In the beginning, this can be difficult because for many of us, we've been practicing for years quite the opposite. Holding the belly tight, breathing into the chest, causes a lot of problems in our nervous system and within our health generally. So if you're finding that through practicing for years, holding your belly in, expanding the chest when you breathe in, it's like we were taught it sometimes, you know, that military breath, belly in, chest out. We're kind of learning to do the opposite here. We're relaxing the chest, letting it, the shoulders fall back down into the mat, we're letting the belly expand. So if you are finding it difficult, you can take like a heavy book like this, and you can put it on your belly. A telephone directory, you can take a bag of rice, put it on your belly, something with a little weight, so that as you inhale, you're pressing against that weight. As you exhale, you're letting the belly fall away from it, okay? And then we're going to start to make that inhalation and exhalation regular. So as you inhale to the count of three or four. We'll do it together in a moment. As you exhale, you're going to exhale to the count of three or four. So next time you draw the belly back to the spine. Inhale two, three, four. Exhale, two, three, four. Inhale, two, three, four. Exhale, two, three, four. Inhale, two, three, four. Exhale, two, three, four. Inhale, belly rises. Exhale, belly falls. Inhale. Exhale. Keep your eyes closed and continue to breathe that way. Observing how it's maybe creating a shift in the way you feel. Maybe you feel your thoughts are starting to slow down. Your mind is a little more relaxed already. You know, here we've got the simplest of practices, even though maybe in the beginning it's difficult to get the regular breath. And yet it's so fundamental, so powerful, really. Balancing our state of mind and balancing our nervous system. There's so many complicated practices and yoga, advanced practices, which those of you that have been on the path for a while, we aspire to. Sometimes just the simple is the most powerful. We're just going to go to another step. So practice equal breathing. As you rest there with your eyes closed, I want to invite you to keep the inhalation at its current rate, which by the way, inhaling for four is a strain for you. Just inhale and exhale to the count of three to begin with. So we're going to keep the inhalation as it is. And then we're going to allow the exhalation to naturally, effortlessly become longer than the inhalation. A doesn't mean you start to effort and push the breath out. It means you just relax right into the end of your breath. So that maybe you're inhaling to the count of four, and you're exhaling to the count of five or six. As you practice, as you become familiar with this, you'll be able to exhale to the count of eight. Or if you're inhaling for the count of three, exhale to the count of six. So we're breathing in and exhaling at a ratio of 1 to 2, which is strengthening that parasympathetic nervous response, which is really what we want to work with in this program in so many ways. As you'll read in your guidebooks, as you'll hear in the audiobooks, audio modules for this program, we're overstimulated generally now. That goes for everybody, with a few exceptions. And a few moments in our lives, maybe when we're not. So we're turned on to sympathetic nervous system state much more than we're actually naturally programmed to be for health and balance in the physical, mental and emotional bodies. So as you lie there, continue to allow your exhalation to lengthen. And observing the effect on your state. And start to observe the journey of your breath in through the nostrils, down through the throat. Feel as you inhale, the breath travels down the front of the spine, into your sacrum, into your belly. As you exhale, it leaves the belly, travels up through the torso, through the throat, through the nose. Inhale, follow the breath traveling down through the throat, into the belly, out from the belly, chest, throat, nose. In a moment we're going to leave this practice. So on your next exhalation, lengthen out your legs. Bring the feet together. Reach the arms up overhead. Interlock the fingers. Turn the palms towards the wall behind you. Reach the heels away from you towards the wall in front of you. Taking a good stretch. Chin down towards your chest. And then release the arms, roll onto your right side. Pause here a moment. Feel the connection of your body with the mat. Just ground a little bit through this right side. And then bring both hands to the floor. Push yourself up to sitting. Okay. So maybe, probably, you feel a little calmer after that practice than you did at the beginning. So if you're new to the practice, just keep working with it. Start with a regular breath, inhaling for 3 or 4, exhaling for the count of 3 or 4. And then when you get that, when you feel the system start to settle, your mind start to quiet and the thoughts start to slow down, then support that even further by lengthening the exhalation. Remember, we're not pushing the breath out. We're just going to invite ourselves to relax into the end of the breath. So we're strengthening that parasympathetic response. Core to the work we're doing here, core to all the practices we're doing on this program. Once you get used to doing the practice with the knees bent, then you can come to do it in what we call corpse posture, shavasana, it is in Sanskrit, but you don't have to worry about that. Corpse posture, relaxation posture. So you lie basically like a corpse. Feet are a little more than hip distance apart. The arms are about a 45 degree angle from the body, and the palms are turned up, fingers soft. You let the feet drop out. I think you can just about see mine in this clip. We keep the chin close to the chest. To the centre of the chest. If you have lower back issues, it's maybe not comfortable for you to lie like that. In which case, you just take a rolled up blanket. If you've got a bolster, that's great, but a rolled up blanket will do, or a pillow. Place it under your knees and lie back with support around the back of the knees. Palms up. Okay. It's preferable not to have anything under your head, but I find some students, when they first start to lie back, they get a little dizzy, or they start to feel a little bit nauseous. So it's in exceptional cases, it's in rare cases, but it does happen. Particularly if I find where there are blood pressure issues. So in that case, you can take a cushion, just a little cushion, and place it under the back of the head. So you keep the head raised a little bit. But preferably, we just want the neck to stay in neutral. So we want the chin tucked down a little bit towards the chest as you lie back, and nothing underneath it. So only if you really need it. Okay, so you're going to use this practice for some of the practices that are going to follow in the audio audio sessions of this module 1. And also, you're going to use it for the meditation practices. This breath practice, both the equal breath, 1-to-1 ratio, inhaling for 3, exhaling for 3, or inhaling for 4, exhaling for 4. They're both a great way to come into the meditation. And then once you've got that, to start to allow the exhalation to lengthen is also a great way, of course, to settle everything so that we can practice the meditations nicely together. So for the meditation, you can take a bolster or a firm cushion and come to an easy cross-legged position. So one ankle under the opposite knee is probably enough in the beginning. So we call this easy sitting pose. For many of us in the beginning, it's not easy, in which case, take a straight back chair, like a dining chair with no arms. You put a cushion on if you like, put something behind your back, but you don't want to be really slouching into it, into the back of the chair. You want to be upright. If you're using a chair, both feet on the floor, no legs crossed, feet flat, no shoes, but you can put a little blanket or a cushion underneath your feet so that your feet are comfortable, your feet are not cold, you feel supported. So main thing is that the back is straight. Then also we can feel the belly moving in and out. It's going to be difficult to get this abdominal breathing for some of you sitting up until you've got it really while you're lying down. So it's easier lying down, legs bent. Then you can try laying down, legs straight. And then once you feel, okay, I'm getting the hang of this, try to come and practice it seated, cross-legged with the hips supported. What we want ideally in the cross-legged positions is that the hips are below, the knees are below the hips. So you can even lift yourself a little more, you know, you can lift yourself like to the height of the equivalent of three telephone directors if you like, so you can keep piling up the cushions, but firm cushions, so you really feel the hips can lift, not that you're sinking down and the lower back is not collapsed, is not supported, but collapsing. We want the lower back to be long, not rounding, okay? So you can lift the rib cage off the hips, roll the shoulders down, place the hands on top of the knees, or classical meditation posture, we're turning the palms up, we're bringing the forefinger and thumb together, okay? So you've already relaxed a little bit in this session, so let's just have a go. Close your eyes. If you need to get a chair, just take a chair, pause the video, take one, bring one over, make yourself comfortable, feel your back straight. Feel as if there's a string on the crown of your head lifting you up. And close your eyes. And start to feel your breath without changing anything. Next exhalation, draw the belly back towards your spine. Inhaling, relax the belly. Exhale, draw the belly back. Relax the belly to inhale. Remember, we're breathing through the nose. And look for that equal breath. Okay. Equal inhalation, equal exhalation. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale, let the out-breath be a little bit longer. Inhale. No straining in the breath. Exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Continue to breathe like this. Few more moments. Find your rhythm. Find a breath that's comfortable for you. Keeping your eyes closed. Following your breath inwardly. Inhale to the count of 3 if you find you're straining. Exhale to the count of 4 or 5 in that case. Three more breaths like this. And now take a really strong inhalation. And as you exhale, open your eyes. Maybe bring the palms together, rub the palms together, create a little heat. Let's just finish nicely, nourish ourselves a little bit. And then bring the cup of palms over the eyes. fingers traveling up the forehead. Just feel the warmth from your palms coming in to soothe your eyes. Bring the hands to a prayer position. Bring your thumbs to the midpoint of your chest. Lower your chin to your chest. And just give yourself a little thanks, a little thank you here. Acknowledge the good work you're doing, the time you're giving to yourself for your own healing, well-being. So you can more fully live the life you were born to live. More fully love and serve those around you. And when you're ready, you can open your eyes, lift your head. Okay, thank you. So, well done. What I'd like you to do is practice this over the next few days. When you wake up, if you can, before you do anything, get out of bed, lie down, have your yoga mat out already somewhere in your bedroom, lie down on the mat, practice the abdominal breathing. It's important to do it first thing in the morning before the nervous system starts to get activated with the busyness of the day and everything you've got to do. If that means you have to get up 10 minutes earlier, it's going to be worth it. Okay, this is going to set your nervous system up for the rest of the day. It's also going to support you into getting to the routine with the rest of the practices. So 5-10 minutes, start with the regular breathing and then go to the ratio of 1-2 breathing, longer exhalation than inhalation. Do it lying down to start with over the next few days. We'll come to doing this sitting up when we do the meditations, to bring you into the meditations. Start with the knees bent when you're lying down. Once you're comfortable, start to practice with the legs straight in that corpse posture, that relaxation posture I showed you. Okay. Ideally, I'd also like you to do this 5-10 minutes before going to bed. You can do it actually lying in bed if you like this one. It's a beautiful way to fall asleep, relaxing into the end of your exhalation. And, if possible, a little time midday. 5-10 minutes. If you're in the office, you can't go and lie down, just take 5-10 minutes practicing the abdominal breathing in the chair then, during your lunch break. Okay? It's going to be worth it. You're going to feel the difference and it's going to support you to bring in the other practices in as we go through the program. All right? Thank you. Namaste.